Hey guys, your Burger Herbers, and welcome to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Karma. Why is there a brand new feel? Well, as you can tell by the title of the video and my a hopefully better sounding audio, my new mic did indeed arrive on the Monday. Got a good one this time. Probably because it was coming from the same country. But hey, what can you do? So, yeah. I have to say, it looks great. And hopefully, it sounds great. Because that was the whole point. I'd hate to think that I wasted my time and my money to better my quality for you. The viewer.
This is a very intriguing group. We had a couple of games for each club now, and now we're on to match day three.
Someone said to me, why am I upgrading my equipment if this is not my full-time job? And I can see why they would say that, but my reply was, well, even if this isn't full time, that's the one. My viewers.
No booking from the referee.
To,
get the free kick.
Who, you know, get the best that he can get. Where it be sound, visually. I mean, if I didn't give it rats to backside, why would I have gotten an Elgato for the visual? Why would I have bought this mic? Just because it's not my full-time job doesn't mean I don't want to give you guys what the best that I can, and hopefully you can do that. And I don't have the best equipment. I'm not the best talker.
So effusive.
Generally, there's lots of YouTubers than me. But
situation.
That doesn't matter. That doesn't matter to me, and it shouldn't matter to you. Because this, I want my channel to be like a place where people just come.
And that will be Liverpool.
Hear me occasionally say my opinion on things, and yes, since my new mic is here, that controversial video, it's coming. I'm going to be recording that some bitch tomorrow. The salt will rain. It'll be fucking glorious. This wish. If I could, I would play that on loop during the whole video. Although that might drown me out. But still. I can't wait. I can almost taste the salt now. That's how salty people will be. Because some people are fucking idiots. That's the world we live in. You say one thing or another, and people get pissed. It doesn't matter what you say or what you've done. People will get pissed. And they won't accept what you have to say. Because they have to be right. Because they're fucking morons. You see, people who have mental problems shouldn't be allowed on the internet. But they are. And here we are. There are people out there. Look out for them. You can generally be freaking locate them because of their name.
Well, this attack has got a bit of menace to it.
It's fucking disgusting.
Quick into the tackle, and the result is going to be a throw. Felipe Luis.
So. Yeah.
Defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball. And he could get away here.
Keep an eye out for People like that. People who are just fucking awful. And just can't accept another person's opinion or when I get to it first. Or follow instructions. Simple, basic instructions. I mean,
they've thrown the ball away there.
Like, the world has rules, right? I'm not the only one who knows, you know, laws, that sort of thing. You know, like, don't steal, don't kill people, don't do that, any of that shit. Am I the only, do I imagine those? Are those not laws that we have to follow? Does that mean if I want to kill someone, I can? Because apparently those laws don't exist? No. Those laws do exist. Yes. And rules exist. Like, if you go to a swimming pool, there's a rule in most swimming pools that you cannot run. And you have to have a shower before and after. Or, wait. Do you go to a swimming pool, run, just don't give a shit? And do you fucking say, fucking need a shower? People go to the toilet in swimming pools. Well, you know that, right? That rule is there for a reason. Now, yes, some rules have their reasons and some rules don't. But, if you are in charge of something, you're allowed. Or you at least have the option to put in whatever rules you want. I mean, look at the US. Everyone's watching as Trump is putting a fucking ban on travel of some description. He's either banning Americans or into certain countries, or he's banning people from certain countries traveling. I'm not fully following what's going on in America because I don't give a shit. And it's not my problem because I don't live there. But he's the president. He can put those laws into effect because some idiots decide, Trump is crazy, racist, and rich. He's perfect for the presidency.
He's done well there, defender.
So, I just don't understand. You put one little rule. And you're probably saying to yourself, what the fuck is he talking about? Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. But if there's a rule, why would you question it? Why would you say, no, you can't do that? Excuse me? I can't do that? I'm in charge around here. I make the rules. You follow them, or you get the fuck out. That's the whole point. It's just mind-boggling. You know?
There's the kickoff for the second half of this third.
Anyway, in the group stage, enough of my rant. In that first period, but I think it'll with the
onto the attack now.
Controversial salt-inducing video you're gonna get tomorrow. That means you got a double upload. Because one friend of mine did ask, will that affect regular upload? No.
Good defending.
You will still get a secondary career movie. Oh, just like you would on Tuesday normally.
Make a note of this particular date. EA Sports.
And by the way, did
the Premier League fixture.
Who among you saw my video yesterday? The Uncharted.
Really looking forward to this one.
Playthrough who began? I died a few times. Needlessly. And yeah. Yeah, that happened. But hey, what can you do? You have to learn some way, I guess.
No wasting time.
You don't learn from your mistakes. Your character's probably gonna die.
Well away from the danger zone.
Or in FIFA Casey would probably conceal it, eat some goals.
And in goes the cross.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is another reward.
The defender who got there first, quite good stop by the goalkeeper.
But they don't fucking matter, do they? Nope.
Half an hour to go.
And we're just gonna pretend that they don't, because some people will get fucking triggered if you fucking mention rules.
Here the challenge is a good one. A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball. Diawara.
Hey, 2-0. Alright, with the second goal, I was wondering where the hell it was coming. Somehow he got there before the keeper.
Because
may have taken a punch to the cheek for his troubles, but hey, well,
and they've got a goal.
And one little you're all right, champ. Nudge to the cheek. Don't do any harm in the long term, right? Right?
2-0.
I think.
Return ball.
So, yeah, that second goal.
Challenge.
Like to get a third goal just to wrap up the
this is an exercise in patience as they try to
game. Damn it. Some more. Oh my god, how did I miss that?
Try and increase their lead.
How did I miss that? Mind blown.
20 minutes now remaining. Diego Godin. We are going to see a chance.
Hey, Oliver Torres. I remember when I used him if... I think it was FIFA 14 career mode. I thought he was very good. I haven't used him in any FIFA since. Anyone else have those players that, you know, use those briefly, and then you're like, he was good, I'll use him again in the future, and then you just, like, never use him again for whatever reason? Or am I just weird like that? Because that's happened a lot. There's always that player that you say, he was good, I'll use him again. Like, now sometimes they completely ruin that player. EA, thank you very much.
Atletico Madrid have a
and sometimes it's a randomly generated player like my like someone like Feyor here. He's not a real person. Well, there might be. He's someone with that name. But
by the defending side.
I very much doubt there's an actual... Well, like I said, there could be someone with that exact name looking to break into football, but the odds of that would be unbelievable. Like, they'd be on the level of getting the odds that Sutton and Lincoln would make it as far in the FA Cup as they have.
He wasn't fazed by facing the player who's already got the better of him in this game.
Hey, this will be going out around about the time that Arsenal are going to be playing tonight in the FA Cup.
3 minutes. He's coming forward.
I'm a little disappointed. I was kind of hoping for the big underdog final. Well, but the draw had to go and ruin that, so it'll happen in the quarterfinal if Arsenal aren't victorious tonight. So, yeah.
Liverpool have got the goal. I'll talk about luck. The keeper makes a good save, but straight into the path of the attacker. That's given them a comfortable situation here.
I guess quarterfinal is good enough too, right?
Well, it turned out
I mean, no one was expecting them to get past the first round, let alone to quarterfinal. And that would guarantee one of them would be in the semifinal. Which, accomplishment for small teams like that. It's like Leicester all over again.
Ajax, nil.
Hopefully they won't crash and burn like Leicester are currently doing. No offense, Leicester fans. We're playing next, so that's a guaranteed win for you, so don't worry about it. 3 points incoming, because Liverpool will come to...
PSV.
Yeah, we're playing the King Power.
Paris Saint-Germain.
Didn't it used to be...
Borussia Dortmund.
Did Leicester move stadiums, by the way? Because didn't their stadium used to be called the Walker Stadium? Ignore that. I guess it used to be called the Walker Stadium. For ages, I thought it was called the Walker Stadium because of the guy he from the Walkers was the Leicester legend. Maybe it was, I don't know. Oh, one person told me it was because Walker Crisps owned Leicester, which maybe they did, I don't know. Anyway, it's called the King Power now, so good on them. Anyway, Newcastle is the next stop. Where are Newcastle in the table? 13th. Well, I don't plan to be struck by the unlucky streak or whatever the fuck is associated with 13. Seriously. This supernatural mumbo jumbo is complete fucking bullshit. Right? I mean, just think about them. 7 years bad luck if you break a mirror. I've broken a mirror before, and you get lucky from time to time. So, yeah. Suck it. Granted, it's breaking the mirror was a complete accident, but I still broke one. It was only the corner, but I still broke it. I don't know. To this day, I still don't know how I broke it. I barely touched it. But, yeah, whatever. 7 years, bad luck. I mean, later that same evening, I found something I thought long lost. So, yeah, unluckiness. And step on a crack, you break your mother's back. Okay.
To today's game.
Question. How does that affect people whose mothers are A,
for both these clubs, wasn't it? And Newcastle
passed, B, already in a wheelchair or whatever else comes from a broken back, unable to walk on crutches, etc. I don't know. I've never met anyone who's broken their back, so forgive me if I don't know how it works.
Top defending this season, you have to hand it to Liverpool.
I just assume you wouldn't be able to do much.
Because they just love their clean sheets.
Maybe you would, but I don't know. I mean,
big reshuffle for Liverpool.
I suffer from back pain, and I am in agony anytime it flares up. So, having to deal with a freaking broken back, jeez, Christ, that would suck. But I don't know.
Confirming for us here that
you guys can give me feedback of some description.
To keep the ball out of his net. Well, he is his own harshest critic, this lad, and he'll blame himself for that, I think, having got a touch.
7 goals for Sadio Mane.
Aside, the home team, that is, who have got 8 wins in a row behind them. They really will be eyeing up the chance to make it 9. It's a daunting prospect for the visitors.
Nice early goal as well.
Defend well here, that's for sure. Attacking now.
Something to build on.
And he bangs it away.
Or I could just give the ball to Bertrand.
That's a good idea too, I guess.
Tackle goes in. Typified the competitive nature of this game, that tackle. It's only a throw-in.
Oh, crap. Here comes the... I was expecting them to...
the ball.
Maybe go into, like, a cutscene or something. I was just about to take a fucking drink of water.
Here's a chance to attack.
I could end the battle.
Mario Götze.
Mario Götze.
Well, they're building steadily here, working away. Trying to keep the ball. Not anymore. Free kick awarded against Liverpool.
Of course.
Here's a replay again.
Give me a chance to take a ring of war,
though.
There's an upside to that.
I don't think he can blame himself too much there, goalie.
Miscommunication. Or whatever the hell you want to call it.
Alan McAnally's at the Britannia Stadium today, and he's got some news for us, Alan.
Okay, just give me back the ball. That's a great idea there, Newcastle.
Well, he's...
Hey! It's an own goal! Oh, I did not know why Mario Götze is celebrating. That is not his goal whatsoever. He's been bundled in, and the Newcastle fans are confused. Their player scored, but it's at the wrong end.
It's his responsibility.
Maybe
those
are Liverpool.
It is. You'd like to try and defend him, but he just didn't make up his mind quickly enough there.
Some friends who they know are Newcastle fans. Could be the case. Handley with the own goal.
Bad enough.
It wasn't very handy there.
Do it with an own goal. It's particularly annoying for
that
the team and the
work,
player in
it?
Question. Good strong tackle. Strong, fair challenge. Balls out for a throw though.
Star Wars here.
Tova.
Oh, he showed great anticipation there.
There's some potential in this move. It is about making decisions.
Oh my God!
It wasn't a very good decision to shoot.
I do not know why I went for a long range.
In the stadium.
Right there, but I did. But it ended up badly.
And that goalkeeper can just saunter.
Ain't worth chasing that ball, was it? Come on, win the header. Yeah, Joel. Beautiful pass to Mane if he can make it. Ah. Oh. Matip.
Nathaniel.
Go on, Philly.
Use the full width of the pitch here to make some.
I'll take the throw.
There'll be a throw now after the tackle. On the attack here.
Manny whips it in. Origi. 3-0. 3 was good enough against Atletico Madrid. I have plenty of time to get more than 3 here against Newcastle because. The third goal against Atletico Madrid came in
that was so
in the 90th minute.
Great ball, great goal.
Well, it was just perfect from the delivery to the finish.
Could you put less effort into it, Origi? Freaking. Just stand still, fucking nod it. It make Newcastle look like a bunch of fucking amateurs. Great job.
Call back.
What an asshole. Seriously, I love seeing the players do something like that. Just
Nathaniel Clyne.
Just gives me like a connection.
Good forward play from them. Jack Colback.
Come on, win that header or drop to your feet there, Joel. That's good too. Manny?
Can he shut off now? Oh. What a fine save.
Or might be my last chance.
Okay, coming up.
To get the fourth goal before halftime.
Right into the
in.
Defender to it first.
Freaking callback with the bicycle kick clearance. Only as far as the sideline being for a throw.
David Alaba. And here's the shot.
Alaba.
Steps for the attackers to feed on from the goalkeeper that time. Hung on to the ball.
Aye, aye, aye. Well, half time. I'm okay with a 3-0 at half time, but
the first one sided
game. Which is probably what every Newcastle fan
a timely challenge.
Arena is probably thinking as well.
Got some up to the minute news from Alan McAnally. He might be through.
Chris,
and that news from
X to pass it, and he passed it to the goalkeeper. I know you're leaving in January, Emery, but for fuck's sake, play for the club you're playing for right now. Plus,
it's a good way to nick the ball back.
He won't be in the Premier League coming January. I will not accept a Premier League. No matter how much.
We have so much covered for you on EA Sports, including the EFL Cup fixture for Newcastle United. They'll be hosting Watford.
Yeah, a lot of people already saw this one.
Looking forward to it.
Right,
we could be in.
And
shots on here. And yet again,
Mane,
the main man for his side.
Ooh, he's young. He's got great potential. I mean,
two very well taken goals.
I could turn this team into a team of fucking badass as young talents.
That's a possibility.
So they're looking for more.
The fourth goal from Sadio Mane.
Giotto.
After going a few games without a goal, he seems to be finding his footing now.
Through the 90 minutes, half an hour to go.
It's a post-Gorey drought.
Coming on for Newcastle. The score! Oh, well saved.
Gorey goals, it's a big accomplishment.
The cross coming in.
You have to remember, only our player to hit that at the moment, other than Mane, is Cristiano Ronaldo.
I'm afraid that was off the radar.
Not a lot of company, but a hell of a fucking company in that one in person.
Jonjo Shelvey.
Now, Ronaldo didn't drop off in the following season. In fact, he fucking matched. Well, he did previous season and scored 40 again.
It's Mane.
But
there's good progress with this attack.
Mane,
and here comes the counter attack.
We'll have to wait and see. But
well, they've been thwarted here.
He's not come out firing all cylinders as he has the past two seasons.
Ryan Bertrand. Johan Gufran.
So, who knows? And we might have a new addition to this group soon.
Just over.
It looks like
15 minutes to go. Mario Götze.
Pick a player from my secondary career mode.
Moving away.
Actually scored her for it.
Stopped emphatically and just
as well.
He's
only three off.
The approach play looks very encouraging.
Trying to break the Dutch.
Team playing the ball forward to open up.
Sorry, Belgian league record.
The defending was good there by the opponent.
Leeds,
yeah. Jonjo Shelvey.
Back, and we'll see how he progresses.
Newcastle on the ball
towards his goal. Really on the next.
Oh, he's through.
In tomorrow's career mode, Lane enjoying the group then.
There's going to be a throw in after that tackle. On the attack here.
Got it. It's make a substitution. Gonna bring on Emery Moore just for the last few minutes. See if he can't give us a bit of a shot in the arm of the old adrenaline. Sorry, Mario, but not really. That sounds like a harsh criticism. As Joel Matip tried to get anything on that. It's in the goal.
Ryan Bertrand. And the time to be added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes. Jesus Gámez.
That's the full-time whistle. As brace from Sir, you know, man. An own goal from Hang.
Crystal Palace 2, Chelsea.
And,
Derby County 0, West Ham United 1. Leicester City 1, Manchester United
2. Oh my god, I completely forgot who scored the other goal.
United 0. Stoke City 1, Arsenal 1.
Sorry. I don't remember. For the league tables. I just played it and I don't remember.
Liverpool with 27 points. In second, Manchester City with 18 points. In third, West Bromwich Albion with 17 points.
Now, well, you guys can go back and rewind if you don't remember, but I'm going to have to rewatch the video. Well, I'm going to be rewatching it anyway, but to just find out who scored the goal. Anyway, in the next episode, I will hopefully not forget who scores.
In eighth, and
fourth, happened right in front of me.
With 12 points. Bottom of the table, Derby County with 1 point. And then reading up the table,
I will,
second bottom,
hopefully,
Middlesbrough with 4 points. Third bottom, moving down, are Aston Villa with 8 points.
He produced
and falling are Newcastle United with
some
9 points.
Magical well, on the pitch
moving
moments.
Down are Swansea City with 9 points.
Because what hell not? In my games against Plymouth and Sunderland. So don't miss the next Liverpool Chroma of here, which will be up on Wednesday. Tomorrow you'll get a double upload of the video that will reveal the truth and the secondary Chroma, where a record may be broken. There's just every possibility. So hit that subscribe button if you're new to this channel. Or smash the like button if you enjoyed this video. And till next time, I hope you like the sound of my new mic. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.